Number 10, the Dim Torch. This item was probably going to be part of the scrapped secondary profession called survival skills, which you needed to make the basic campfire and other survival skills. I mean, I say others, but it was literally just the campfire and torch. It is theorized that some zones in WoW were going to be a lot darker than normal and would need some kind of light to navigate. So the dim torch might have been used for that. The torch itself has a limited duration of only 1 hour, required the item Unlit Poor Torch to make, and gave everybody nearby a 4 spirit buff like the campfire does. Although on screen it should say 4 stamina, but it used to be 4 spirit. So it was like having a campfire you could walk around with, and kind of functioned like a real torch, as it could only be lit for a limited time. Now, the model for this torch did end up making it into the game as other items. It's just this crafted 1 hour duration buff giving torch never did. At number 9, we've got the War Paint shirt. Not good for the ladies, NYI. This shirt was basically just tattoos on the chest of your character. I assume it was a test for how adding tattoos for players could work out by adding them to shirt items. Today, the only characters with tattoos are demon hunters, so it might have been testing for that, even. Now, you may have noticed that the item also mentions not good for the ladies. And that's because if you use the item on a female character, the tattoos go over the bra. I guess what it was trying to say was that it wasn't designed with female models in mind yet. Which makes sense when you look at the female model with a shirt on. I assume if they continued the idea, they'd eventually add a female option to these shirts too. Like they did with the female demon hunters and their tattoos. At number 8, we've got Teagle's Trashbringer. Now, last time I mentioned this item in a video, people remarked on the weird way I pronounced Teagle. Apparently, it's Tiggle, as in Tiggle Bitties, because it's a play on words for big old titties. Yeah, I didn't know that. I can see why you guys found it funny I pronounced it that way. Anyways, this item was included in the alpha version of Wrath of the Lich King and given to new Death Knights. It did terrible damage and only vendored for 1 copper, so it's not like it was very useful. Although it did have the model of the Ashbringer, which wasn't in the game yet at the time, and was most likely just put in for fun. For those of you who don't know, the Ashbringer was one of the most sought after, never added to the game weapons for the longest time. People had all kinds of crazy theories in vanilla WoW about how to get one that involved fishing, doing AV, and ooze in the plague lands, and a few other things. During Legion, Blizzard played homage to all these rumors by requiring you to do things similar to the Ashbringer rumors from vanilla to get the hidden artifact appearance. But none of that really has anything to do with the Trashbringer. It's just a joke item that had its item quality upgraded to artifact quality in Legion for no reason. At number 7, we've got the unfinished Mammoth Mount models. In Wrath of the Lich King, we got the Traveler's Tundra Mammoth, a brand new mount that not only allowed you to carry other party members in its side, but also had vendors that sold food and drinks, and repaired your gear. In Cataclysm, we got the Sandstone Drake, the only way to fly another person around that didn't require you to do recruiter-friend shenanigans, and was great for helping out low-level players. In Mists of Pandaria, we got the Grand Expedition Yak, which, like the Traveler's Tundra Mammoth, had a repair vendor plus a reforger. So no longer did you have to go back to town after getting a new piece of gear, if you wanted to reforge it with the correct stats. You also had the first edition of the Water Strider, allowing all players to walk over water without needing a special skill to do so. And then in Warlords of Draenor, to top off the previous expansion's additions of brand new types of mounts, we got the Reforger and the Yak Mount replaced with the Transmog guy. Also, we got another Water Strider. That is to say, nothing new was added. But there are these unfinished Mammoth Mount models in the game files that were added in Warlords of Draenor, which probably might have been a new kind of mount. But just like everything else in this expansion, was most likely scrapped so that they could work on Legion. So many things planned for this expansion were scrapped. In fact, I have a video going over a few of the things that I'll link in a little card on screen, and at the end of this video if you want to check it out. Number 6, the Onyxia Scale Breastplate. This item was going to be a craftable item in vanilla WoW that required the scale of Onyxia as one of its crafting materials. Now, what makes this unique is that the Onyxia scale was only ever used for crafting one item, the Onyxia scale cloak. A cloak that was almost required in order to progress through Blackwing Lair, so it was in high demand. So having other uses for this scale seemed like a no-brainer, and it's a wonder why Blizzard never added the breastplate. The breastplate didn't really do anything special like the cloak, which was used to prevent a one-shot mechanic, so maybe it was removed so that people wouldn't be tricked into crafting this subpar item with the scales that were needed for the cloaks instead. Who knows? It seems like it'd be a good idea to have more things to use a crafting reagent on than just one item, but I guess not. Number 5, the powerful smelling salts. Today, the only people who can res other players are classes with a healing spec and classes with a battle res. Also, engineers sometimes with jumper cables that don't always work. But in the game files are items called powerful smelling salts that were slated to be a first aid item with the effect of rezzing a dead player. If these salts did manage to make it into the game, every single player would have the ability to rez other players, like we used to have when we still had the mass rez guild perk. I still think smelling salts would be a cool thing to add to the game today, especially since they removed the mass rez perk. I mean, they'd only work on one player, and you'd still have to craft them, so it wouldn't be anywhere near as bad as mass rez. Number 4, the pet fish. This item would summon a dead pet fish. I think this item was supposed to be a play on why they couldn't have aquatic pets as companion pets, before they added the little bubble to pets in Pandaria that a lot of fish-like pets have today. The tooltip for the item says, "He used to look healthier," which makes sense since it is a dead fish. I can probably understand why they never added it, and probably wouldn't today, with, you know, the whole bubble system being a thing now. And at number 3, we've got the knowledge rogue items. Rogues in vanilla WoW had two extra class-specific professions to level up: poisons to create the poisons for the weapons, and lockpicking, which had to be a level up like any other profession and required the rogue to go out into the world and open footlockers, like how a miner would go around the world and mine ore. You want to know how many other classes had a class-specific profession in vanilla? That's right, none of them. It was only rogues, which is probably why the knowledge items were never added. Knowledge items were recipes that required the rogue class to use. These recipes allowed the rogue to create disguises of various NPCs from vanilla WoW. Rogues in other fantasy games and lore are generally really good at disguises and sneaking into places by dressing up as other people. So these items fit the rogue fantasy perfectly. And each disguise required you to loot random things from the NPCs you wanted to transform into. In fact, some of these items required for these recipes did make it into the game and just straight up served no purpose, other than vendor trash, since the knowledge recipes were never added. Of course, some of the items, like the Red Defias Mask, just ended up becoming popular vanity items as well. Now, as to why these recipes were never added to the game? Well, probably because rogues already had two other class-specific professions at the time, which was two more than all other classes. So why add a third? Of course, there could be a whole bunch of other reasons, but that's my best guess. At number 2, we've got the Frostmourne. For an item never added to the game, it sure has gone through a lot of changes. The sword has been in the game file since the launch of the game in vanilla WoW, and wasn't used by any characters in-game until Wrath of the Lich King. The item and stats were shown off at BlizzCon one year, and also mentioned that it would never be available to players. When it was shown off at BlizzCon, it was shown to be of an artifact quality, and in-game files appeared like that as well, only with a few changes to its stats and meta socket being added, which was a gem type that used to only appear on helm items, so it was weird seeing one on a weapon. It was also later changed in the game files to appear as a poor quality weapon with no stats, terrible damage, but still has a meta socket on it, strangely enough. I've heard by people who managed to equip the item on private servers that the buff it gives, which reads as the wielder of Frostmourne will become the new Lich King. Just gives you a cosmetic buff that doesn't really do anything else. Now, seeing as the item was shattered by Tyrion at the end of Wrath, and Frost Death Knights craft the pieces that were left into their artifact weapon, I doubt this item will ever be added to the game. And at number one, we've got Martin's Broken Staff. This item has the really useful effect of committing suicide, which instantly kills the player. I mean, I guess useful is subjective in this case, as I'd assume most people would call that anything but useful. It's also a poor quality weapon with no stats, and a super fast attack speed of half a second for some reason. You know, I think this might be one of the fastest weapons in the game now that I'm looking at it. Anyways, this item used to be a GM item called Martin Thunder before patch 3.3, which had plus 100 resistance to 4 different schools of magic, and had a little more useful effect of killing all enemies within 30 yards. Now, the reason this never released item got such a drastic change is most likely because of the Martin Fury disaster, where a GM accidentally gave a player the shirt Martin Fury, which had a similar effect of allowing you to instantly kill enemies within 30 yards, which the player then used to kill a whole bunch of bosses in Old War with his guild. Considering Martin's Broken Staff got changed to its less than useful state around the same time this incident happened, is good enough support for this theory to me.